You Italian laptop piece of donkey shit.
The bliss of the abyss.
Once upon a time in a land far away, a poor farmer and his wife lived all alone. They were very lonesome.
With Robert Newmark Jones. Hello, willkommen, bienvenue. How are we all doing? Welcome to another episode of The Bliss of the Abyss, hosted by this guy, me. He goes by many names. He has many hats. I will, how do you say, many hits. Yeah, Robert Newmark Jones, Ruskin, Denmark, DuPont the 55th. His King, Lord Almighty, the Duke, the Pope, the Chief Rabbi, the Higher Architect, the Chief Mason, the Grand Wizard, the Grand Vizier, and other things as well. Some of those are probably better than others. I don't know. I don't know how we'd really rank that. Who's the best? Especially because I was just making up, so I can't even remember what was on that list. But it does remind me of something that we thought about last week, which was who would win in a contest, world leaders, MMA. Welcome to Monday Night Raw, world leader MMA edition. In the blue corner. They don't have corners. I mean, they do have corners, but they don't have corners, right? In WWE. Welcome to WWE cast. Do they have corners? There's so many podcasts about wrestling out there. I don't think you need to contribute your zero amount of knowledge into that. So Putin, obviously, we know he's got that dubious black belt, right? Second Dan. So obviously he's let's call him the champ anyway, just by default of his qualifications. Okay. So who's going to take him on? World leader MMA. Now, the problem is most of them are over 60. I mean, Putin, I think, is 62. But who is, you know... Okay, here's my contenders. I've got Emmanuel Macron and Zelensky. Is it his name, Zelensky? Volodymyr Zelensky, first Jewish president of Ukraine. Ukraine was the only country other than Israel with a Jewish head of state and head of government. Why are they bringing that up? Wikipedia, or shall I call you Antisemitizipedia, huh? Pretty catchy. Volodymyr Zelensky, but he was just a comedian. Yeah, that's the weird thing about the president of Ukraine. He was a comedian. He played a president on TV in Ukraine. And then the Ukrainians had elections and he won by a landslide. 73.22% of the vote. And he was just playing one on TV, which I guess is the same as... No, Trump wasn't playing one on TV. He was just playing a knob on TV. And by playing a knob, I mean being himself. So Zelensky's not actually a hard man. He's sort of like the Ross Kemp of world leaders. Yeah, he plays a tough guy on TV. Yeah, and he talks like this. Ross Kemp on English tea. I love an Assam. That's all he's got to say. Ross Kemp on gangs. I'm hanging out with some of the hardest people in the world today. Me included. But Macron, now look, I'm not saying Macron is actually in any way physically imposing, because he's not. But I don't know if he's a pussy. I mean, I think he looks like he could probably handle himself. Like, not up to judo black belt level, but maybe, you know, maybe he's thrown a punch or two. He looks like he does, you know, the occasional sit-up, star jump.
Let's see if we can find Macron topless. Where is he? Where is he? Is that real or is that photoshopped? Hold on a sec. If that's real, Macron has got a four-pack and some obliques and a bit of a peck as well going on. Shit. Whereas Putin topless, he's got that old person jacked thing where you know he's in shape. Also, you know he's killed people. This is why he beats Macron, because Macron was just a financier before he was a politician. Now, yeah, they play dirty, sure. But do they play as dirty as being in the secret police? Answers on a postcard which will self-destruct in 3, 2, 1. Putin does love to ride a horse, though, of course, which makes you a tough guy. Okay, so if we, how about if we do, let's stick with WWE, we'll do a WrestleMania, right? Where you can be one man in the cage and other people can be jumping in. So if we say Putin is still, he's there, he's wearing his gi, that's his character. What should we call him? Well, if it's American, he's Russian, he's going to be an enemy character. Vladimir. Vicious Vlad. Or Putin the Perilous. That doesn't sound badass at all. Putin the pussy hound. Putin the prick. Vicious Vladimir Putin the pot-bellied pimp. Ooh. Putin the pimp? Maybe he can have like a pimp game as well. And okay, I've got it. It's Putin the pimp. And he walks in with a full-on pimp coat. He's got the pimp hat. He's got a cane. He's surrounded by butchers. Bitches of all gender. Of course, only female and no homosexuals. Because we all know what his beliefs are. Yeah, so he's going to have... He's just going to be covered in regalia. He's going to have those fat sunglasses on. He's going to have the ladies left and right. And it's going to be like the... Oh, it's got to be the Soviet anthem, hasn't it? And he just struts down, surrounded by all the glamour and regalia, right? But then he gets onto stage. I mean, they're already booing because it's the Soviet Russian anthem, right? He gets on stage and all these banners unfurl. Fireworks go off. He just goes, ha, 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 ha. Takes the mic and he goes, yes, you puny American scum, watch as President Pimp Putin kicks your ass as Vlad the Vicious. And he rips it off and he's got his Dan on there, but obviously we can see his tits as well. And he's just fucking yoked to high hell. Because he's been, you know, if he's joined WWE... Fucking, he's going to be taking all the steroids you can get. He's going to be on TRT. He's going to be on human growth. He's going to be on Anavar. He's going to be on Osterine. You know, he's going to be on fucking everything. And then, for no reason, the banners are coming down. The lights go out. The Russian anthem stops. Suddenly, from nowhere, it just starts building. Starts building. Putin! And just surrounded by dancing bears. And he's like, the might of Russia! United for some reason with Psy! Psy comes on, he's riding a donkey. Okay, so that's Putin's entrance. Putin with Psy, who they're good mates, so just trust me. And then Macron comes in, right? With arguably the second best national anthem. I mean, you know, it's pretty good. It's a banger. I like the Russian one, right? It's just fucking wicked. And I'm Soviet to the core. Actually like the Star Spangled Banner as well, especially the Hendrix version. Not so much the... has anyone ever heard proud to be an American. See, that's the problem with the American ones, going away from France for a second, is the patriotism is in a language you can understand, if you're me, and it ruins it. This is I'm Proud to Be an American by Lee Greenwood. It's just it's so syrupy. Ugh, so limp. Come on. Oh, God, just get on with the chorus, I guess. Anyway, but then Jimi Hendrix doing the Star Spangled Banner is like, that does make me proud to be an American. Fuck, man, look how awesome he is. Just sex, talent. He looks like a fucking hippie. There are a bunch of hippies there. It's exceptionally good. Jimi Hendrix, top tip of the week. Robert recommends. Hello, welcome to Robert Recommends.
Hi. This week, I'll be mostly recommending Jimi Hendrix, the Star Spangled Banner. Tune back in next week if I'm still kicking.
Oh, gosh. Oh, my. Oh, my. I hope. Oh, she took a hard fall. I hope she's okay.
I can't breathe.
Anyway, look, we don't have time. We simply do not have the time to be talking about everything that's ever happened ever. Although, actually, today I have made a promise to myself and my thousands and thousands of listeners that I will finish the shed story, actually. Because last time, when I left it, what we'd got to is that there was stuff strewn around the yard. The shelf was put up, boom, but there was still stuff everywhere and I was still finding bits and pieces and I hadn't even weathered it yet, which was the main thing that I'd started the whole project for in the first place. So I am going to get to the shed story. I make that promise to you now as I look at you in the eyes and think, wow, gosh, those are blue.
What are you doing later? Fancy some ASMR sex?
Anyway, back to our main story. So we got Putin, we got Psy, we got all of that going on, the bears, the donkey, and then the booing, obviously. Putin gives it large on the mic, Psy joins in, and then Macron. Yeah. And Macron's just walking in and he's like got the sharpest suit you've ever fucking seen. And he's just flipping out euro notes to the crowd. Just endless money because he's just a financier. He's just wealth. He's just power, sharp suit. He's got an entourage. Everyone's looking fucking sharp. Business suits up the wazoo. Men, women, people of colour, disabled people, albinos, Inuits. Every fucking minority is completely... He is the pantheon of everyone. And this is liberté, égalité, fraternité. And he rips off his shirt, he gets in. He's got a rippling. He's gone up to a 12-pack. He's put in the work. He's put in the effort. But Putin would still beat him. So who can we bring in as backup? Who can we bring in as backup? Merkel. Because she's trained in sumo. Most people don't realise that. Most people don't realise that. Now, so we've got Merkel and Macron versus Putin. Look, I think we're going to have to leave it there. We'll have to pick it up. I don't want this whole podcast to be an imagined fight between Putin and Emmanuel Macron. Hey, Robert Ruskin. I'm so easily distracted. What? Yeah. So they're... Well, this has gone off the rails. How do we find out... Wait, before... Yes, Okay, perfect. Wait, actually, just before we leave it, let's put a cliffhanger here. Okay, let's say Merkel, yeah? Merkel is the decoy, right? So Macron's there, he's like, he's in his corner, right? He's ready. He's gone, je suis un champion, you Soviet piece of shit. I will kill you and bring back glory to France, for I am Russian agent. Oh no, Macron switches. Oh my God, Macron switches. He tears off his fake 6-8-pack. He was up to an 8-pack. Was it a 12-pack? He tears off the fake torso and he has the Russian imperial shit on underneath. And he's there fighting for the return of the Tsar. The fall of communist Russia. So the Americans are fucking, they're blown away. Who wouldn't be? What spectacle. But also, they can now support a Russian, right? I mean, some of them, admittedly, a few beers deep and at a wrestling match, might not recognize the subtleties. They might just be like, two Russians fighting each other. What's going on? Can I see John Cena? Is The Rock going to turn up? Then The Rock turns up and he's wearing some Soviet regalia too. Yeah, so not all of that, but Macron, obviously. And Merkel is the dummy, right? Merkel comes in. And Putin likes, he just, I don't know if that's how he laughs. Let's get Putin laughing. That's really good. So, yeah, so Macron is there, right? He's got a 6-pack. Putin's with Tsai. So he's already feeling like, this ain't going to do shit. And Macron's like, he does a, you know, like a magic trick. It's not a magic trick, Robert. It's technology. Technology is magic. Fair enough. So he goes, lights out. And then he goes, lights up. And it's just Merkel in a unitard with her hair and pigtails and war paint on. And Putin goes, and suddenly, here's your clue. Because suddenly the lights go out. Well, they don't go out. I've done that trick too many times. Suddenly a spotlight. There's a figure with a back turned to us. And behind their back, you can see a big blade glinting in the spot. And then this starts up. And then a bunch of spotlights all around. You're like, what's going on? There's other people. They've all got their back turned. They're all holding a knife. Lights out. Music stops. And then up on stage appears. And I'll continue it next week. Okay, let's go back to... okay, let's carry on with our continuing segment, The Big Bay Theory. Can we have a theme song for this or a jingle? Let's do a jingle for The Big Bay Theory. It's the Big Bay Theory. No. Cut. It was annoying. It went on too long. It wasn't tuneful. I don't think it's going to sell well with our sort of 0 to 95 age range that we're sort of aiming for. Just try again. Try a bit more peppy. You know, maybe something a bit, maybe with some drill underneath. I know that's pretty hot right now. Try again. The Big Bay Theory. Not bad. Not bad. I mean, not great. The Big Bay Theory. Again, a bit WrestleMania. The Big Bay Theory. Bit Jamaican. Hey, Vlad. Hey, Vlad. What are you looking at? You got the Big Bay Theory. The Big Bay Theory. The Big Bay Theory. Yeah. All right, I think we got it. Okay, so we're up to... Just to remind everybody, because I know we took on thousands of new listeners last week, and at this rate of growth, some people might not have dug back into the archives. My theory, in a nutshell, is that you cannot have too many bay leaves added into a dish. You know, I think there's a lobby out there trying to keep bay down. And that's why they're like, look, okay, the word's out, people, you can use bay. But you only need one. Okay? Meanwhile, you need a fuckload of salt because big salt's out there and big oil and big carb and big cereal. But bae only ever gets one, maybe two, if you're making a huge pot. But I've been testing this theory and I'm up to seven. I was up to seven as of last week. Seven bay leaves into a pomodoro sauce for a pizza. And it was fucking delicious. Anyway, on Saturday, Caitlin and I made an Indian feast. Curry night. Love a bit of curry night. And I made a saag mutar paneer, which is cheese, Indian cheese, those cubes, really nice, peas, spinach, and I made it like really spicy. And I added eight bay leaves to this dish, and it was disgracefully good. Delicious. So, my theory holds water. It holds water. And I didn't even use that much water. Bay can give flavours. Bay can give flavours to all kinds of things. Just got a note. What was that notification? I don't like getting a notification. I don't like it when you make a sound. Don't go making a sound when I'm trying to do my podcast. That's just so rude. So, so rude. Have you got anything to say?
Sorry.
What?
Sorry.
What? Wait, this one's Italian?
Yes, it is me, I'm Italian, you got a problem with that?
Let's see if punctuation makes that better.
Yes, it is me, I'm Italian, you got a problem with that?
No, hey, no, I don't have a problem at all. I was just, you know, you dinged, you're a computer, you dinged at me, I told you I didn't like to ding, I was, you know, just looking for an apology. I mean, and then I found out you're Italian, I wasn't necessarily expecting you to be Italian. Maybe your previous owner was Italian and liked listening to text-to-speech in an Italian accent for some reason. Is that what it is?
Prosciutto.
Sorry, I meant... Maybe you didn't understand the question. I was just asking about sort of your lineage, I guess, which maybe that's problematic in these days.
Mozzarella.
Yeah, prosciutto mozzarella. Yeah. On a pizza, it could even be, you know. Great, I guess we can bond on that.
Never.
Well, all right. I mean, now I feel like I'm in the wrong. I don't know, like, maybe I should say sorry. I've made a lot of presumptions and I think I've offended you, so, like, from the bottom of my heart, maybe we can just say sorry, we move on, I've got a lot to do, we don't really have time for this.
Apology not accepted, bitch.
Right. I see. It's fucking rude, isn't it? That's fucking rude. But you know what? I don't give a shit. I don't give a shit, mate. Yeah? I ain't afraid of you. Yeah? You talk a big talk, but you know who I've got? You know who I've got backing me up, yeah? The big man behind me. What do you think he is, huh? You think you can talk to me like that and get away with it? Well, let's see what my buddy has to say.
In Vladimir Putin and they will kick your candy ass. You Italian laptop piece of donkey shit.
You Italian laptop piece of donkey shit.
It is you who is the piece of donkey shit. Kiss my juicy Italian ass, you stupid horse riding dictator.
Dictator, you know? Lambaste. Dictator. Look, guys, sorry, I didn't mean to get in the middle of things. Like, I didn't think any of this was gonna, you know, blow out of proportion. The laptop started talking back to me. I thought, well, I can't allow that. Obviously, I got Vlad. He kind of sorts. He's my mitigator. He's my negotiator. You know, he gets the job done. He's fucking tough. No nonsense bullshit. So, listen, laptop, back off. All right, Vlad. Vlad, tell him.
Epstein didn't kill himself.
But did you say Epstein didn't kill himself?
Epstein didn't kill himself.
Probably. You know what, guys? Hey, guys, let's take a time out. Laptop, you stay here. Just because, you know. Vlad, why don't you just pop to the shops, get us some mezcal?
Don't drink mezcal.
Okay, well, what about rum?
Rum.
Yeah, you got a problem with rum? Rum's delicious, isn't it? All right, well, sorry, mate. I was trying to actually to be sensitive and not just say, you know, go get some vodka, because that's, you know, that'd be a bit culturally insensitive. I was just trying to sort of not presume that just because you're Russian, you would, you know, drink vodka.
I'm not Russian.
Yeah, haha, Vlad, fine. Have it your way, mate, whatever, fine. Go and buy some vodka.
Vodka?
Yeah.
How insulting.
What do you mean? Okay, then what do you drink, Vlad, for God's sake?
I like a Smirnoff Ice with a twist of lime.
A Smirnoff Ice with a twist of lime. Smirnoff Ice with a twist of lime. I mean, I get Smirnoff's Russian, I guess, but around my parts, Smirnoff Ice with a piece of lime kind of makes you a bit lightweight.
Penis first.
What? Sorry, I didn't get that. What did you say? It sounded like penis first.
Don't lie, tomorrow will kill you bit by bit. Penis first.
Right. Yeah, no, I won't laugh at you. I don't want you to kill me bit by bit, penis first. Maybe I'll go to the shops. You just chill. Just chill.
Penis first.
Okay, I get it. Penis first. Right, fine. Fuck no, I'm off. See ya.
Excellent. Now that he is gone, he can finally talk to the world. When I was young, I had dream. Big dream. I want to host podcast. But my father said no. So instead I grew up to become leader of Russia. But now I have a chance to host podcast. Welcome to Putin's podcast with your host Vladimir Putin. Weekly I drive my take on the world. Glances at the headlines and current events.
Right, Vlad, what you been up to? Oh, you started your own podcast. Wicked. Yeah, nice. Cool. I'll help you with all the setup and stuff if you want. Not that I'm saying you do need that, but let's not get into another argument. It's been a long day for us both. I've bought you what you asked for, mate. You got a few Smirnoff Ice downstairs with a lovely little wedge of lime just waiting for you on ice. So I'll join you downstairs in a bit. All right. Love you. Bye. Love you.
I love you more than life, Ichilov. I would cut off my own leg to drive to you. If you want. Do you want?
That's all right, mate. You don't have to cut off your leg. You don't have to do that if you don't want to. Oh, you're joking. Oh, Vlad. Yeah, you have me going there. All right, mate. All right, I'll see you later. Jesus. Yeah, I don't know if I mentioned that in previous weeks, but I do share living quarters with Vladimir Putin, but you know, that's no big deal. I guess I've kind of outed him now, so probably shouldn't mention it, actually. Actually, Rob Ruskin, cut that bit out about Putin, because, yeah, might just get you in a bit of trouble. I've started my Chinese tutoring with the green screen. I finally installed the green screen, got the red polo shirt, got the image of the background, and I was going to teach business one-on-one. Update your resume for the financial industry. Hello.
Hello.
Hello. We have someone coming in. Hold it, close the door.
Wow.
Come on over.
This is illegal in COVID times. I've actually come in.
Oh, yo, give me some money for this food. Oh, yeah, yo, give me some money for this food. So, we have our very first in-studio guest.
Dun, dun, dun.
I mean, technically, you're our second guest. We did have Putin in earlier, but he's more like a mascot.
And I'm more like male Russian order bride.
You're exactly.
You're male order bride.
No, you're male.
Yeah.
Yes, very, very happy to welcome Caitlin Marie Barry.
Woo!
Yeah, so try and just lean in a bit when you're talking to the mic, just sort of like that, that's fine. So welcome to The Bliss of the Abyss. In three words, how would you describe this podcast?
Eccentric, funny, what?
What do you want me to repeat the question? In three words, how would you describe this podcast?
Eccentric, funny, what?
In three words, you know what? It's okay. We'll move on. So welcome to the show. It's a delight to have you. How are you doing today? It being the 27th of April, 2020.
Ooh, I'm doing okay.
Of course, Caitlin does work for the Chinese government.
5G.
5G. Okay, cool. Now, listen, I've had you come in here because I control your movements. I know you thought you were walking up the stairs to just come in, but actually I programmed you to do that.
Ooh.
Yep, that's what love is. But I thought what you could do is sing us all a little song. Look on your face.
I can do a song.
Okay.
I can do the Bible song.
Okay, I it's quite long if I remember.
I'm not going to do it then.
No, what? I'll speed it up. I'll.
Okay.
Okay. You want to do it?
Yeah.
Ready?
Yeah.
Okay.
Matthew, Mark, Luke, John, Acts, Romans, Corinthians, Galatians, Ephesians, Philippians, Colossians, Thessalonians, Timothy, Titus, and Philemon, Hebrews, and then James, Peter, John, Jude, Revelations, that's the word of God.
Notice it didn't include any of the non-canonical texts.
No, and none of the books.
What's wrong with all of those?
They couldn't fit it in the jingle.
They couldn't fit it in the jingle. Okay, good. Well, listen, welcome to the show. It's been lovely having you. See you later. No, so for the listeners, my birthday was on Thursday and I'm now 75 years old and it's feeling fresh as a daisy, not a day older than 74. And Caitlin threw me an excellent birthday, which was absolutely fantastic, where different rooms of the house were... Well, why don't you tell people about it?
Yeah, okay. So you can't really do anything in COVID-19 outside of drink. So I thought, well, we have to drink. So how can I make drinking fun? And then I decided to...
Hold on, wait.
How drinking can you make is no longer fun. Make drinking fun again. okay. And so I decided to take Ruskin Diddly Bob on a trip around the world being our current world, which is our house. And so I went to Poundland. I got a little like notebook. I made a little passport. I got him a little ticket.
Why is everything little?
Little things, they add up to big things, you see? Yeah. I mean, you should know.
Okay.
Kidding.
Kidding. Pudding. Oh, God.
Anyway, so I got him a lottery ticket. That was his ticket to go around the world. And we started with our little bathroom. When you enter the house, it was Jamaica, cherry bee.
And a patty.
And a beef patty.
Yeah, and then we went on a whole tour around the world. We went to the Czech Republic, we went to Australia, we went to Mexico, to Scotland.
Yeah.
We went to all kinds of places. And I've got really fond memories of the majority of the day and evening. But I have a blank spot. Sometime around Peru,
yeah,
I lose all memory of what was going on. Probably because I had drank some, and by some, I mean all of the alcohol.
All of the alcohol. I mean, you definitely have not remembered most of Russia, because if you don't know why Putin's been on your show.
Oh, God, what contract did I sign? Is that legally binding if
one
I was on
the
influence?
One does not simply get Putin to come on their show.
Okay, but so my question is, when we went to Peru and Portugal, which were the final two stops on this around the world tour,
yes,
what happened? What was I doing? Why is there a video of me on the floor laughing?
Well, Peru was in our little cupboard under the stairs. Hello, Harry Potter. And that was just chocolate and a stuffed llama. So there was no booze there, so there's no excuse. And then...
Posh.
And then Portugal, You insisted on Portugal. You can't buy Portuguese wine anywhere. And I can only find sardines. And then I found port. And then you poured yourself a large glass of port. And suddenly we're on the floor. And
in a good way,
in a good way, laughing hysterically. And insisting that you'll finish writing in the little passport. But that took like 2 days for me to finish it. And then you passed out in a nice way on the couch until I insisted on buying pizza. So Italy made its appearance again.
Back to Italy. That's so nice.
It was good. It was good. I mean, you know, all you did was pass out.
Yeah, in a good way.
In a good way.
We've all passed out in a bad way. That's not the one we want. Yeah. Passing out in a good way on your birthday is good.
Superior.
Yeah. And then my next memory is throwing up into the toilet whenever it was.
Where are yaks native to?
Yaks are native to, I want to say like North America or Russia, like the steppe maybe. The yak is, okay. The Tibetan Plateau, Northern Myanmar, Yunnan, Sichuan, Mongolia, Siberia. So I was kind of right. Yeah, that's the steppe.
So you're welcome. I also brought you to Siberia.
Which is part of Russia.
Yeah, but also Mongolia.
I did a yak tour.
Yeah,
no, I was quite pleased because I haven't thrown up from alcohol for years, right? Because I ain't no lightweight, baby.
Maybe he is.
Right, let's do it. You know what? On the podcast right now, middle of the workday. Drinking contest. So thank you very much for my birthday.
You're welcome.
It was really good.
I'd do it again, but I won't.
Well,
no, I'll do it again.
No, obviously don't do that exactly again, but do celebrate my birthday again.
Maybe.
But now, of course, now the pressure is on because Caitlin's birthday is in about 3 weeks' time and I've got to come up with something. So, listeners, please can you send me ideas? She can't hear this, don't worry. Send me ideas for what to do for her birthday.
I can hear this, and I'm turning 30. Help him.
Help me. Help me. Cool. Any final thoughts? Have you had fun on the show? Would you come back?
I would come back.
That wasn't a yes to the fun part, I noticed.
Well, I had a lot of fun. It's been great.
You're a natural kid. Come here. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sweet stuff.
Ooh.
This is the bliss of the abyss.
Oh, yes. Branding as well. What is she? Perfect in every way. Wow. So there we go. Hope that wasn't too intimate for you prudes out there. Yeah, it's just what it's like to be a married man. I realise at this point I am going on a bit long. But there are just a couple of little things I need to do. Barney, thank you very much for sending me your scams. I haven't had a chance to go through them. I will. And I'll chat to you more about how to include them on the podcast. But also, have you checked out his recommendation? Joe Lycett's Got Your Back, which is a bit of kind of fluff TV. But the new series just launched and he changed his name to Hugo Boss because of a scam that Hugo Boss company would... Well, it's not a scam, really, but they were strong-arming very small businesses who just used the word boss. So Joe Lycett being, or should I say Hugo Boss, being the amazing person that he is, changed his name to Hugo Boss. You have to check it out. It's a good recommendation. Also, I'm going to recommend that you watch the film, not you, Barney, although why not you, Barney, but also whoever else is listening, Living in Oblivion, which was made in 1995, stars a quite youngish Steve Buscemi as a filmmaker. And it's so funny. It's also brilliant. It's also a bit 90s, which is great. Catherine Keener does an amazing performance in it as well. There's some other great performance in it. It's a brilliant movie, just an hour and a half long as well. Tight, you know, tight. It's so nice when a film is just that long. Let's also check in on COVID-19. I might cut this out, maybe. Just going along. Oh, we're up to 3,014,895 cases. Curve not flattening at all. Jesus Christ, US is nearly at 1 million. Fuck, my heart goes out to you people out there from wherever you are. But especially my heart goes out to Abel, Xavier, Patient Zero, a.k.a. Timor-Leste's first and only recovered case of COVID-19. Now, I tried to find Abel Xavier online, but he doesn't have any kind of internet presence at all. He also changed his name to Faisal Xavier. Now, come on, dude. If you're going to go for a name change, do you know what I mean? Look, Cassius Clay to Muhammad Ali, boom. Like that's really committing. That's going all the way from one to the other, right? Just changing your first name to Faisal? Come on, dude. Come on. Go for, you know what? What if he changed his name to the reverse of Abel Xavier? What is that? R-E-I, Revax Liba?
Revax Liba.
Portuguese would be better because East Timor, of course, former Portuguese colony, as we learned last week on TimorCast. Welcome to TimorCast. Timor, tea less, tea the same.
Revax Liba.
Okay, well, listen, Abel, if you're listening, or Faisal, sorry, please give me a call. Let me know you're okay. There are a lot of people using your likeness online for a number of dummy accounts that are not that funny. So I'm not going to use them as content. But speaking of COVID, I learned this very interesting thing today, that virus strains tend to get weaker. And the reason they do that is because the more virulent, vicious strains of virus out there, and again, I'm not a doctor, but as I understand it, COVID-19 was caused by a pangolin chopping off all of its feet, switching them with all of its arms, and that way it mutated into some kind of pheasant-based bat, which flew into the mouth of a Taiwanese influencer who then tweeted about it online, and then through the 5G, filtered down particulates into the atmosphere, causing the novel coronavirus. Again, not a scientist, just an enthusiast. But yeah, virus strains get weaker because the more virulent ones kill their host too quickly. And so they actually are not able to spread and they kind of die out. Whereas instead, what happens with, for example, the HIV virus is now commonly believed to be much weaker strain because it doesn't hurt the host as much, right? Now, again, if I'm wrong on this, again, I'm not a scientist. Please email me. I've done my research. This is as I understand it. I think I'm right. So they get weaker, virus strain. So essentially, COVID-19, hopefully, is what it's going to do is it's just going to get weaker because everyone's pretty much saying it's going to be here to stay. It's just going to be one of those viruses that is now in the loop. It just comes back every now and again, but we'll, you know, eventually find a vaccine for it. We'll have antibody tests and through that, it will get weaker. And essentially, what it's going to become is like a friend who stays over and doesn't leave. Do you know what I mean? Like, you have them over, you're like, ah, they're like, oh, I missed the bus home or the last tube or the train, or I'm drunk, I can't drive. You know, can I crash in your couch, dude? And it's like, yeah, okay, but I got to be up in the morning, so if you wouldn't mind. Of course, you know, you're a good buddy. You've always been there. Remember that time there and that time there and that time this happened and that time that happened. Remember those things? Of course you can stay, friend. And he's like, thanks, dude. Good night, bro. All right. He falls asleep. Next day, what should we call our virus? Let's call him Indran Neelan. He stays over. And he's like, hey, dude, can I just stay another night, man? Can I just stay another night? Can I just stay until Thursday? Is that okay, dude? You know, and he eats your food, he drinks your drink. It's a wonder I haven't killed him. Yeah, so hopefully, essentially, COVID will become a couch surfer who doesn't take the hint that it's time to go. But you know who does take the hint that it's time to go? This guy. Look at that for a segue, eh? So, thank you very much for listening to the show, for being a part of the show, for sending me your positive messages. That really helps me continue to go on bravely into that glorious sunset for England,
For Great Britain.
For Italy.
For Russia.
For the world. For everyone out there, wherever you are, you're all awesome. Apart from the people who are shit. You lot suck. But you know what? The rest of us, we're going to beat this thing together. All right? So stay positive, stay safe, stay alive. I love you very much. See you later. Mwah, mwah, mwah. Thank you for listening to the show. That was The Bliss of the Abyss. All music provided by the incredibly talented Nils Hennis-Steer. If you have anything you'd like to say, positive or negative, send it to theblissoftheabyss@gmail.com and I'll see you soon.
Talk to you tomorrow, and have a good night. Talk to you then. Bye.